Meanwhile, rescuers have called off the search for victims of Sunday's Russian missile strike in the Ukrainian city of Dnipro. The death toll from the incident has reached 45, including 6 children. 20 people are still missing. Emergency services say the search and rescue operations at the site of the attack have been completed. The Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky vows everyone who caused what he calls terror would be held to account. The attack triggered the resignation of a Ukrainian presidential advisor who sparked an outcry by suggesting that Kyiv could have been responsible after intercepting a Russian missile that then fell on a building.
The U.S. begins to train Ukrainian soldiers on how to use a Patriot air defense system to combat Russian missile strikes. About 100 Ukrainian personnel arrive in the U.S. this week for their training. Washington promised a Patriot battery to Kyiv late last year to help counter relentless aerial attacks by Moscow.
Training has begun, as we've talked about before. That training will last for several months. And train upwards of 90 to 100 Ukrainians on use of the Patriot missile system. And so those troops have arrived at Fort Sill and have begun their training.
The training comes as the top military chiefs of the U.S. and Ukraine met for the first time in person. The meeting took place in Poland. They were said to have exchanged perspectives and assessments on Russia's invasion of Ukraine.
Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now with our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Good morning, guys. Here are the latest stories making headlines amongst the Filipino community.
We begin in Washington, D.C., where U.S. President Joe Biden marked the Martin Luther King holiday on Monday by speaking at a breakfast organized by civil rights advocate Al Sharpton's National Action Network. Ahead of his expected announcement in the coming weeks that he will run for a second four-year term in 2024, Biden claims he has done his part in providing services for Black Americans in his 2 years in office, particularly in economic growth.
The unemployment rate is the lowest it's been in 50 years, and Black unemployment is near record lows. Wages for Black workers are up. Two strongest years ever for small business creation, including Black small businesses.
Black voters played a major role in Biden's victory in 2020 after he pledged to do more to defend voting rights and address important racial justice issues.
And the Constitution of the State of New York, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of Assembly Member to the best of my ability. So help me God.
Meanwhile, it was a proud moment for New Yorkers as they gathered Sunday at the Queen's Museum to witness the oath-taking of Stephen Raga as the first Filipino-American Assembly member in the state of New York.
Finally, more than a century, we have a Filipino-American born in the United States of two Filipino parents who is now our assemblyman, Steve Raga.
U.S. and New York state officials led by Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer, who administered the oath of office, joined community leaders of diverse cultures in showing their confidence for the District 30 assembly member.
It was really high time that we elected Filipino-American, like to any office in the state of New York, let alone the New York State Assembly.
I'm honored to take this solemn oath before you and uphold the Constitution of our great state and our nation. Today, I'm humbled by the outpouring support, filled with gratitude for the duty you've entrusted upon me, and excited on the possibilities of what's coming to our state on the horizon.
Finally, we go to Los Angeles, where hundreds of Filipino faithfuls held one of the most popular Philippine cultural and religious festivals, the Sinulog. With a theme of feast, family, and faith, people celebrated at the Cathedral of Our Lady of Angels this past weekend.
We do it out of love for our devotion to Señor Santo Niño.
As images and statues of the infant Jesus filled the church, these devotees also brought with them their prayers.
Long life, health,
and long life.
Yeah. No more pandemic.
Yeah.
Back to normal life.
And no matter where these Filipinos are from, the sights and sounds remind them of one thing.
It's like we're in the Philippines. We're always celebrating it every year. So it's very nice.
And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.